We're going to start by looking at how to convert just one clause from CNF to 3CNF. This is going to be the heart of the argument, because we're going to be able to apply this procedure to each clause of the formula independently. So consider this one clause consisting of literals Z1 through ZK. We're going to have three cases, depending on the number of literals in each clause. Note that I've left off k equals 3, since nothing needs to be done in that case. When there are two literals in a clause, the situation is easiest to understand. We just need to boost up the number of literals to 3. To do this, we include a single extra variable and trade in the clause Z1 or Z2 for these two clauses here, one with the literal Y1 and one with the literal Y1 not. If, in a truth assignment, Z1 or Z2 is satisfied, then clearly both of these have to be true. On the other hand, taking a satisfying assignment for these clauses here, the Y literal has to be false in one of these two clauses, and so therefore Z1 or Z2 must be true. We can play the same trick when there's just one literal, Z1, in the original clause. This time, we need to introduce two new variables, which we'll call Y1 and Y2. Then, we replace the original clause with these four. Note that if Z1 is true, then all four of these clauses are true as well. On the other hand, for any given truth assignment for Z1, Y1, and Y2 that satisfies these four clauses, the Y literals have to both be false in one of these, and that then implies that Z1 is true. Lastly, we have the case where K is greater than 3. Here, we introduce K-3 variables and use them to break up the clauses according to this pattern. Let's illustrate this idea with an example. Consider this sixth literal clause here. Looking at this, we might wish that we could have a single variable that captured whether any of these first four literals were true. Let's call this variable Y3. Then we could express this overall clause with just three of the literals, Y3, or Z5, or Z6. At first, I said that we wanted Y3 to be equal to Z1, or Z2, or Z3, or Z4. But actually, it's sufficient and considerably less trouble for Y3 just to imply the truth of one of those literals. This idea is easy to express as a clause. Either Y3 is false, in which case the implication doesn't apply, or one of Z1 through Z4 better be true. Together, these two clauses imply the first one. If Y3 is true, then Y3 bar is false, and so one of the Z1 through Z4 must be true, and so must the original clause. On the other hand, if Y3 is false, then Z5 or Z6 must be true, and so must the original clause. Also, if the original clause is satisfied, then we can set Y3 equal to the disjunction of Z1 through Z4, and these two clauses will be satisfied as well. Note that we went from having a longest clause length of 6 to having one of length 5 and another of length 3. We can apply this strategy again to the clause that's too long by introducing another variable Y2, and trade this long clause in for a shorter clause, this time one of length 4, and one of length 3. Of course, we can play this trick again, and eventually we have just three literal clauses. This example is for k equals 6, but an inductive argument will show that the argument works for any k greater than 3.